Spirit of the Lord, your people have come from various communities. They have come with varying circumstances, maybe obstacles and challenges. They have come to look to you, the author and the finisher of our faith. I ask you now, Lord, to descend in your power. Descend in your majesty and in your glory. Relieve the oppressed ones among us. Heal the sick ones among us. Lift up the fallen. Strengthen the weak. Give hope to the hopeless. And oh God, vision to those who are without a vision this morning. I pray that the worship anointing will rest upon all of us heavily, so that every yoke in this house will be broken. Those by television, those by the internet, on this first day of the new year, I pray that it will bring new and fresh blessing upon all of your people. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, may the enemies of our soul be defeated. May sicknesses and diseases disappear in the name of Jesus. And may the oil that ran down Aaron's beard to the skirt of his garment flow upon every person today. In the name of Jesus, let not one leave out of this house when we shall have gone to the end of the service the way they came in. But let God arise for every man. Let God arise for every woman. God arise for every boy and every girl. And let the enemies be scattered. Oh, glory. Yes, Lord, as I can sense the holy anointing beginning to flow upon this audience, let it flow from top to bottom. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the Son of the living God, move upon us right now. Speak into our lives. Break every yoke and every fetter. And we, oh God Almighty, shall give you the glory, shall give you the honor, shall give you the praise. Satan, the blood of Jesus Christ is against you. Unclean, diabolical spirit from hell, we serve you notice right now in the name of Jesus, and we command you to take your flight. Go back to the pit of hell and let God arise in this house for all of his people. Oh, glory. We speak life, we speak health, we speak healing, we speak deliverance. We speak the blessings of God that make it rich and had it no sorrow unto them. And we receive it, no Father. We receive it. We receive it. And we give you the glory. We give you the honor. We give you the praise. We say thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Lift up your hands and open your heart and begin to thank him for his blessing. Hey, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. The Lord bless you. You have a wonderful time as we worship the Lord together. And God's blessings be yours. Receive your touch. Receive your healing. Receive hope. Receive new life. at the commencement of this new year in Jesus' name.
Just wave those hands in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. Just wave those hands. Hallelujah. Just wave them high. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Coming to minister to us in song is the Voices of Inspiration Choir. Please put your hands together and make them welcome in Jesus' name.
Thank you.
God bless you. Put your hands together. Give the Lord praise. Thank you. Please be seated. Allow me to take 5 minutes to minister to these seniors who are here with us this morning, our members who are homebound, confined to their homes due to physical circumstances. I have visited with maybe all of you sitting here this morning. In last week, still have another number to visit in the coming week, but we are delighted to have you in God's house with us this morning. You are the pace-setters. Brother Perkins sitting there in this wheelchair, lost both legs, and not one of us here in this house know what might befall us in the last day. He served the Jamaica Constabulary Force for 35 years. And all of these are wonderful people. We are going to pray with you because some of you will have to leave us now for different reasons. I give you this word from the Holy Scripture, from the 34th Psalm. The Lord has placed it in my spirit for you. From verse 17, it says, "The Lord is nigh unto them that are of a broken heart, and saveth such as be of a contrite spirit. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivereth him out of them all. He keepeth all his bones. Not one of them is broken. Evil shall slay the wicked, and they that hate the righteous shall be desolate. The Lord redeemeth the soul of his servants, and none that trust in him shall be desolate. Although your outward man perish, but your inner man is renewed day by day. Melody is in your heart because of the love of God. Whilst you're confined to your home, etc., as I said to those whom I've visited and ministered to, you have a ministry right there to intercede for God's people. None of them that trust in him shall be desolate." I invite one of the ministers to take some oil and anoint these seniors for me at this time as I pray for you, that God would touch you in a very special way, and that this year will be a year of great possibilities for you, because with God all things are possible. We do not count you out. And anybody count you out, tell them they are making a sad mistake. Job was down in the ashes to skin and bone. But Job declared, "All my appointed time, I wait till my change comes." Hallelujah. We pray for you now that the holy anointing of God will be with you and will strengthen you. Give me a minister to stand and lay hands on every one of them, please. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. We see how today, and we rejoice in our today, but many things about tomorrow we don't seem to understand. So we trust God for you right now. I feel such a heavy anointing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hey, glory to God. Hallelujah. Father, we pray for our moms and dads. We pray for these seniors now. And pray, oh God, that the Holy Spirit will minister to them. Many of them have ran many races, won many victories, oh God Almighty, and have passed on the baton to another generation. We ask you now to minister to them, Lord, from the crown of their head to the soles of their feet. I pray that you strengthen them. I pray that you lift them up, oh God. I pray that you comfort their hearts in the night season. Give them dreams and visions and revelation. Help them to know that the afflictions of the righteous might be many, but oh God, you deliver out of them all. And none that trust in you shall be ashamed. Oh, be their shepherd, 2012. Be their shield. Be their buckler. Be the light in the room. Oh, be their comfort when they become comfortless. Supply all of their needs in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, and those who administer care to them, strengthen those hands, strengthen those feet, strengthen those resolve, strengthen those minds, and bless them now. In abundance we pray. In the name of Jesus, stand by them. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Somebody worship God right now. Somebody give Him praise. Give Him praise. Give Him praise. Thank you very much. The Lord be with you. I want to thank Deaconess Powell and members of her team who have been doing a fantastic job visiting, ministering to our seniors out there. God bless you. See you soon again. Those who have to leave, please see to it for me. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, you see today, you don't see tomorrow. That's it. One day the strong could become weak, the healthy could become sick, the rich could become poor. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. To God be the glory. God bless you. A text from 1 Samuel chapter 16 was read. And I want to bring you a message from that passage, supported by other passages and portions of Scripture. Let us pray. God, we thank you for who you are, for what you have done, and for what you continue to do. I ask you to bless the word to be spoken. May they be quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword. Anoint your servant, make him an instrument of your peace. Bless the hearers of the hearts of your people. May they hear and digest. May the word of God serve all of its intended purposes today in this sanctuary, by radio, by television, by the internet, peoples everywhere. Bless them, we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. From the theme, when you are anointed, you are anointed. Tell your neighbor, when you are anointed, you are anointed. My message to you on Friday night was, enough is enough. But more than enough is not too much. And I want you to carry that theme with you wherever you go. Enough is enough. But remember, more than enough is not too much. So when you're anointed, you are anointed. Bible tells me in Isaiah chapter 10 and verse 27 that yokes are destroyed because of the anointing. It tells me in 1 John chapter 2 and verse 27 that the anointing teaches and guides into the truth. In Zechariah chapter 4 and verse 6, it tells me might nor power cannot effect what the anointing can. Exodus chapter 14 and verse 15, priests were anointed. Acts chapter 10 and verse 38, God anointed Jesus. And having anointed him, the gates of hell could not prevail against him. 2 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse 21 tells me that God anoints the saints. Tell yourself, God has anointed me. 1 Samuel chapter 10 and verse 1, it tells me that kings and captains were anointed. Those who led the people of God were anointed. In Scripture, you will find that persons, places, and things were all anointed. It means to be consecrated. It means to be dedicated. It means to be set apart unto God for holy use. And if ever a time we need some set apart people unto God for holy use, it is now. In Psalm 2, verses 2 through 9, the kings and the rulers of the earth, they took counsel to bring down the Lord and his anointed. But God says in that very portion, I shall break them in pieces like a potter's vessel, and I will break them with my rod of iron. It says, I read it, the kings of the earth set themselves, and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord and against his anointed. Let us break their bands asunder and cast away their cords from us. That's what they say. But he that sitteth in the heavens shall laugh. The Lord shall have them in derision. Then shall he speak unto them in his wrath, and vex them in his sore displeasure. I have set my king upon my holy hill in Zion, saith the Lord. I will declare the decree. The Lord has said unto me, thou art my son, this day have I begotten thee. Ask of me, and I shall give thee the even for thine inheritance, and the utmost parts of the earth for thy possession. 9 and final. Thou shalt break them with a rod of iron. Thou shalt dash them in pieces like a potter's vessel. So anyone who seeks to destroy the Lord and his anointed, God says, I will take charge. And that is the reason why I want to believe God that every member of the body of Christ for this year will be anointed in a way that you have never been anointed before. Because I believe challenges will come left, right, and center. I believe the kings of the earth, the principalities and the powers and the rulers of darkness are going to conspire against God and against his anointed. Lift your hand and say, I am anointed. But when they conspire against God and His anointed, God said, I will take charge of that battle. You need not fight. I will go before you. I sit in the heavens, saith God. I will laugh at their calamity. I will dash them in pieces. I will break them like an earthen vessel, because God will defend His people. Lift your hand and tell the devils around, God defends His own. Hallelujah. Do you believe it today? Do you accept it today? I repeat purposefully, intentionally, I want every believer, regardless of your religious persuasion, I want you to commit yourself to God as you have never done before, so that He can pour upon you not just enough anointing, but more than enough anointing to deal with all hell that will come against you. Oh God, help me in this house. Hell come against you in your home. Hell in the community. Hell at the workplace. Hell even in the very church. But I'm believing God that an anointing will rest upon me. Lift your hand and say, me. To discharge the forces of hell. Satan is defeated and we have the victory. Oh, some of you not acting as though you have the victory. You don't sound as though you have the victory. But the church of the living God, it fights from victory unto victory. His army He shall lead, till every foe is vanquished and Jesus Christ is Lord indeed. Hallelujah. Lift up your hand and declare, Jesus Christ is Lord. Declare it again, Jesus Christ is Lord. Glory. The first reference of anointing took place in Genesis chapter 31 and verse 13. The first act of anointing was carried out there in that particular portion. And it was between God and Jacob. You find there that three very outstanding things happened or took place, almost incredible, unbelievable, when God would condescend to meet with a man and to anoint a man in a particular way in preparing him for the missions that must be accomplished. I want you to consider, before I get into it, this text and the being of Jacob at that particular time. Jacob was a fugitive, running and hiding. On the run and in hiding. But hear me well. When God has a purpose for your life, it doesn't matter how far you run. It doesn't matter where you hide. God will find you. There are some persons whom God will not give a break until you fulfill the mission to which you have been assigned. God will follow you anywhere you go. Well, Bishop, you're theologically incorrect, because God is always everywhere. Yes, I know. But there are specific purposes for which God assigned the Holy Spirit to trail you, to track you, to sniff you out, and to bring you into that which He wants you to do. God could have called it a day with Jonah. God could have left him, but God followed him all the way. When he boarded the ship to Tarshish, God stepped on board. When he went way down deck where the cargo was stored, God went down deck. And God said, I will not leave you. When he became fed up and tired of the presence of God around him, he said to the mariners, throw me in the sea. Let me die in the ocean. They threw him in the sea, and God went down there in the ocean with him. Massive fish came along and swallowed him up. And he thought, this is it. There's no way God can get me out of this. God entered the fish and stick its stomach and say, head to the shore and bring out this man. Vomit him out. He cannot die until he fulfills the purposes for which he has been called. Because when you are anointed, you are not just an ordinary person. You are under heaven's supervision. Heaven's cameras are following you anywhere you go. So fugitive Jacob, running and hiding. David asked a question many, many years ago. Whither shall I flee from thy spirit? Where shall I go from your presence? If I make my bed in hell, behold, thou art there. If I take the wings of the morning and fly to the uttermost parts of the sea, even there your right hand shall hold me. If I ask the darkness to cover me, the darkness hideth not from thee. The darkness and the light are both alike unto you. Because God, you possess my reins. Tell your neighbor, God is in control. Hallelujah. So three outstanding things happen there. Genesis chapter 31 and verse 13. Number one, God revisited Jacob. Because God had visited him before. Are you still with me? Some of you need a revisitation from the God of Israel. Because he has visited, he has spoken. But today you're acting as though God had never visited with you. His eyes are watching you. Somebody shout something there. Not only did God revisit with Jacob, but God reminded Jacob of some things. He revisited him and he reminded him. Lift your hand and say, remind me, Lord. And thirdly, having revisited and reminded him, God released him. God said, I'm going to release you now. Your life of captivity, running as a fugitive, has come to an end. Time to get a special anointing to carry out the task. I would to God somebody would say something. He said, I am the God of Bethel, where thou anointest the pillar, and where thou vowest a vow unto me. Now arise and get thee out from this land and return unto the land of thy kindred. Oh, somebody got to go back home today. Somebody's got to come back home because you are living in a strange land when you live outside of the anointing and the call of God for your life. You are in a strange land. Hallelujah. I wish I could say this, but you think I backslide if I say, I got to go back home. This couldn't be my home. Somebody got to go back home today. Your years of running have come to an end. God is revisiting you right now. And God is reminding you right now. And if you open up to the Spirit, he will not only revisit and remind, but he will release you. Lift your hand and say, release me. Do I have anybody here on this first day of a brand new year who wants a release from Almighty God to fulfill your purpose, to become all that God wants you to become, to go everywhere He wants you to go, to do what He wants you to do, to say what He wants you to say? Honey, you need a release. My God Almighty, somebody wave your hand and say something. I did say something in this house. It was a discouraged but a desperate Jacob. Have you ever seen a desperate person? Oh God of heaven. Have you ever heard the saying, I'm sure you have, a drowning man catches at a straw. He thinks the straw could save his life. Impossible it might be, but because he is in a state of desperation, he believes any stitch in time will save nine. A discouraged Jacob, but a desperate Jacob, who got out of his sleep confident that whatever and wherever and whomever is anointed is going to make a difference. Tell yourself, whatever, wherever, whomever is anointed will make a difference. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody say, anoint me, Lord. God of heaven, some of you wouldn't even open your mouth and say it. When you get this stuff on, you'll realize. You realize that it propels you into greater victories than you have already had. So Jacob was reminded by Almighty God that I need to release you now. It was in Genesis chapter 28, verses 18 and 19. Are you with me down there? Amen. Where Jacob got up out of his sleep, out of his dream, having seen, amen, a phenomenal thing. Angels ascending and descending from heaven upon a ladder that was stretched from earth to heaven. And when Jacob got up out of his sleep and looked around, all Jacob saw was the stones that he had used for his pillow that night. Are you not saying nothing? Jacob saw the stones, and Jacob got a hold of some oil. And Jacob said, I'm going to anoint these stones because God has revisited with me. God has reminded me and God has spoken my release. But I cannot go until I receive a fresh anointment from the God of Israel. Lift your hand and say, another anointing. Another anointing. Yeah, glory to God. Hallelujah. Jacob poured oil upon the stones. And when he poured oil upon the stones, there in the city that was named Luz, immediately things changed around him. Jacob anointed the stones, anointed the place, and immediately the name of the city was changed from Luz to Bethel. What was God doing? God was setting him up for something. Somebody say amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Let me read it. Genesis chapter 28 from verse 18. It says, and Jacob rose up early in the morning. And he took the stone that he had put for his pillars and set it up for a pillar and poured oil upon the top of it. And he called the name of the place Bethel, but the name of that city was called Luz at the first. Whatever is anointed will bring about change. Lift your hand and say, anoint me. Now, some of you think this anointing thing is to jump around and make noise and to do all kind of weird stuff from time to time. Honey, this anointing gives authority. This anointing gives boldness. This anointing equips and enables you to do the work of the Lord, not by might nor by power, but by the Spirit of Almighty God. This anointing lifts up the weak and makes them strong. This anointing brings you from the wilderness and places you in the very presence of kings and queens and nobles. Somebody praise God in this house. Lift your hand and say, anoint me. For when you are anointed, you are anointed, and your world will change. Luz was no more Luz. It became Bethel. Now follow me. Luz means almond tree. What Bethel means? House of God. Are you not saying nothing? So the state of Jacob's life, almond tree could not help him. He needed house of God. And for him to transform that place from almond tree to house of God, he got to anoint. Oh, you're not getting this. He had to anoint the stones, anoint the place, and the moment he anointed it, and I believe he declared under God from today, this is the house of God. This is the house of God. The glory of God dwell here. The anointing of God is here. For you shall decree a thing and it shall be established. For death and life are in the power of your tongue. If you speak it under God by the anointing of God, nothing cannot stop it from coming to pass. For thou shalt say to this mountain, woo! Somebody praise God in this house. Lift your hand and say, when you are anointed, you are anointed. House of God. So he changed the place from almond tree to house of God. Where would you rather be in a time of desperation, in a time of difficulty? Would you rather be underneath an almond tree, or you'd rather be in the house of God? I would to God some of you get this here this morning. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Jacob said, I must change up this thing because God has released me and I need everything around me to be anointed. Touch your neighbor and say, anoint me, anoint my neighbor. Anoint them, anoint them, anoint them, anoint them. Hallelujah. Oh God, if you praise him in this house, if you praise him in this house. Once Jacob did that, he vowed a vow unto God. Verse 20. Genesis chapter 28. And Jacob vowed a vow, saying, if God will be with me and will keep me in this way that I go, and will give me bread to eat and raiment to put on, so that I come again to my father's house in peace, then the Lord, hallelujah, be my God. And this stone, not this man, not this woman, are you not getting this? And this stone. Touch something inanimate around you. Touch the bench. Touch a chair. Touch some inanimate things around you. Oh God Almighty. Glory. And this stone which I have set for a pillar shall be God's house. and of all that thou shalt give me, I will surely give the tenth unto thee. When you get into covenant with the anointing and with God, honey, and you keep your covenant under the anointing, the sky is your limit. Dear God, why are some of you looking at me like that? I said, when you enter into covenant with God and keep your covenant in the Holy Ghost, the sky is your limit. No devil can stop you. No demons can bring you down. No principality can stand in your way. No bad-minded people can hinder your progress. It doesn't matter what they try, who try it, where they try it. Against you, the gates of hell cannot prevail. For when you are anointed, you are anointed. And enough might be for good enough for somebody, but for some of us today, more than enough is not too much. Lift your hand and say, I need more than enough. My God Almighty. Woo! I feel a lot of current going through me. I feel a lot of surges going through me. Holy Ghost, amen, voltage is very high. Because when you are anointed, you are anointed. Incredible things will happen for you. Incredible things will happen through you. Incredible things will happen because of you. It will only be then that one will chase 1,000, and two will put 10,000 to flight, not by might nor by power, but by the Spirit of God. Somebody shout something here. Now take it easy. Today, undoubtedly, many Jamaicans are sad, while others are glad because of the recent event that took place in our nation. Are you not saying nothing? Some folks are very, very, very passionate where their politics is concerned. Are you not saying nothing? But I don't know what you're going to call me today, laborite or comrade. But I'm going to preach in Jesus' name. Some Jamaicans are sad, while others are exuberant. They are ecstatic as to the victory that their party has won. And their candidates have won. And their leader has won. Are you not saying nothing? You see, when you have humankind holding your future in their hand, the balance could go anywhere. You're not saying nothing. You can win and you can lose. When human beings have to decide if you are fit and proper to lead, and by them deciding, they make a vote in your favor or against you, honey, double jeopardy. Could go anyway. But hear me well. Hear me well. Where the church of the living God is concerned, where the Christians are concerned, your future, our future, is not in the hands of any human being. You don't want me to preach the truth? God holds my future in His hands. Come on, somebody. He who caused the sun to rise in the morning and set in the evening, He holds my future in His hand. Yeah, glory to God. I thank God for every politician. I thank God for their sacrifice and serving.
But honey, you can vote them in, you can vote them out. But when the blood of Jesus Christ reaches a person's heart and signed in crimson red in the book of life, you never vote them in, so you can't vote them out. They are under the blood, and when I see the blood, I will pass over you. God, if somebody prays me here, never vote me in, can't vote me out. Because if God be for us, who can be against us? Your life is not dependent on any chance. Your life is determined by Almighty God. He said, I am God that watches over you. Woo! And he said, when you go through the waters, I will be with you. When you go through the fire, you shall not be burned. When the floods come up against you, it shall not drown you. There, God, nobody not praising him in this house. Woo! When you're anointed, you're anointed. We're going to leave the altitude of 32,000 feet and begin our descent, slowly descending. In the text of 1 Samuel 16, God needed a leader. God needed a king. And God called an election. God called an election. Samuel was the director of election. Jesse's house was the polling center. Jesse's sons were the candidates. You don't want me to preach. God Almighty. When God calls an election, God can't lose. God has never lost a battle. You need God on your side, no more than ever. Woo! God Almighty. Somebody wave your hand and say something. God, nobody should sit down looking as though God is not anointing you. Even if you're dead, you're getting some anointing. Wow, glory to God. Jesse's sons were the candidates. 8 sons. Gentlemen and ladies, as MP Fagan and others, 7 were duly nominated. 7 duly nominated. But 1 was out in the field. Nobody called him in the election process because him can't win. David can't win. David can't be king. David a shepherd. Don't bring him in this election business. Leave him out of grass. Let him stay there. Take care of sheep. So 7 were duly nominated. Hallelujah. But listen this. God was the voter. God was the voter. Hold on. Lift your right hand and say, God, vote for me, no God, vote for me. Put a tick beside my name, no Jesus. When God put a tick beside your name, anywhere you are, the anointing will search you out. Anywhere you are, the anointing will find you. Your colleagues might not remember you, but the anointing of God will search you out and bring you home. election open. Director of election, Mr. Samuel K. Send forth the candidates.
Voting time. Tell your neighbor, voting not finished, not finished. Tell them voting not done. The political party completed the process, but the church is always in a voting process, because God is always looking for a man, always looking for a woman, always looking for a vessel to anoint for this purpose. Lift your hand and say, when you are anointed, you are anointed.
Woo!
Jesse said, Samuel said, bring the candidates. Returning officer Jesse said, okay.
Abinadab!
Comfort. Well, first of all was Eliab.
Eliab, comfort.
Abinadab, comfort.
Shimeah, comfort.
We call him Shammah, but his name is Shimeah. Comfort. When Samuel saw them healthy fellow, he said, truly, the anointing of God be upon you. But God withheld his vote. God did not vote for Eliab, Shammah, nor Abinadab. Samuel would have voted for them clean. For man, the Lord seeth, not as man seeth. Man looketh on the outward appearance, but God looks on the heart. You know I'm a preacher, truth. Three sons went through the process. God don't vote.
Nathaniel
came forth.
Radai
came forth.
Hosem
came forth.
Helio came forth.
And all those seven candidates did not attract God's vote. You'd have noticed the voting process the other day. 54%, whatever, of the electorate cast a vote. I don't know what the other 46% were saying, but certainly for one reason or another, them seminar cast a vote. But hear me, and hear me well. God will always cast his vote. But only that. He will be very selective as to who he votes for. Stay with me. Don't leave me. I'm coming down. I'm way down at 26,000 feet. You soon hear the landing gear. Somebody wave your hand and say something.
Director of election Samuel say, election stall. No candidate has been chosen. Jesse, what's going on? I've asked you for all the candidates. Are these all your sons? Tell your neighbor, when you're anointed, you're anointed. And nobody can hold you down. Nothing can stop you. Some of you worrying about two-footed man and woman like yourself. Don't worry about human being. Just keep being in touch with God. Get the anointing on your life, and your enemy shall become your footstool. They either friend you or you trample them. God, can I preach for 5 more minutes in this house? You're anointed.
You're anointed. Jesse said, there is one candidate, you know, but we did not enumerate him because he's not qualified. He take care of sheep. We didn't bring him to the process. Hold on. Let me get a little political now. My views. I strongly believe that some of the candidates who were eliminated on whatever sides because of what, if they were given the chance, I strongly believe some of them would have come home on both sides and not saying nothing. Come on, somebody. But we make our false judgment and we write off those whom we choose to write off. And all when our friends don't pass the test, we give them 95 and 100 honor, distinction and credit. Why you don't let me preach a truth in this house? Tell your neighbor beside you, don't be hypocritical. Tell them, do not be hypocritical. Truth is truth. Man must talk truth. If you're right, you're right. If you're wrong, you're wrong. From King's house to Ham's house. That's what God says. Righteousness exalts a nation. But sin is a reproach to many people. I don't think I'm preaching. Let's bring it down. Samuel said, bring the candidate. But he doesn't have any CXC, CAPE, nor GCE. He has not been to university. Bring him, come. Bring him, come. God is the voter, let him decide. And they brought David. They brought home the candidates. Samuel knew that that was the man. And he said to them, everybody remain standing. We will not sit down until he comes. For when you're anointed, you are anointed. The anointing will search you out and bring you home and set you up. Listen to me. Before Jamaica's problem should be seen as economic hard times, I want us to reckon that Jamaica's problem, first of all, is spiritual. You're not saying nothing. It's moral, it's social, and it's relational. Any dear honorable gentlemen and ladies, we get the spiritual, the moral, the social, and the recreation, the relational rights. God, the economic will take off like wings, with wings like a dove. Any day we begin to live like civilized human beings and honor and respect the God of heaven, things will change. Let's close. So David is out there. He fought lions, he fought tiger, he fought bear. And none could have prevailed against him because he was anointed. Lift your hand again and say, anoint me for this new year. Hallelujah. Get all that you can, my brothers and sisters. Get your houses, get your cars, get your furniture, get your wife, get your husband, get your children, get your job, get your education. Get all that you can, but please, please, I beg you,
I beg you, I beseech you, by the mercies of God. Woo, God Almighty. Get all that you can to facilitate human life in a short existence. But I beg you, please, make sure you take some time out in the morning. You take some time out in the noonday. Or you take some time out in the evening. Or some time out at night time. And bow your knees. And say, anoint me. Anoint me. I must have the Savior with me. For I dare not walk alone. I must feel His presence near me. And in arms around me thrown. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I beg you, Mr. Member of Parliament here. I beg every one of you out there. I beg the Honorable Prime Minister-elect. I beg the Leader of the Opposition. I beg every one of you. Please. He that rule over men must be just. Ruling in the fear of Almighty God. And I beg you, church. I beg you, church. I beg you. Take time out for Jesus. Spend time with Him in prayer. Spend time with Him in fasting. And tell God, the anointing will bring me in. As David was not considered, enumerated, left out there. But because he was anointed, the anointing went for him. Searched him out. And when he came, and Samuel held the horn of oil over his head, God picked up his fire from heaven. God lit the horn of oil. And the oil flowed upon David. And the Bible says, from that day, the Spirit of God rested heavily upon him. And he went from conquer to conquer. When you are anointed. Stand with me, please, everybody. Let me land. Let me stop. God Almighty, lift up your hands and say something. I shouldn't beg you to do that. Oh my God. God, nobody praising you, Jesus. Nobody wants you anointing, Jesus. Nobody praising you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yokes will be destroyed. Burdens will be lifted. Problems will be solved. Unanswered questions will be answered. And all the forces of hell will tremble before you. Yeah. For when Jesus comes, the tempter's power. Sing like you have the anointing of God on your life this morning. He takes the gloom
with glory.
For all is changed.
All is changed.
Oh,
when Jesus comes.
Lift up your hands and say, when Jesus comes.
When Jesus comes.
Oh,
people need it? Only these few?
Dear God.
The dead can found is broken when Jesus comes. All tears are wiped away. He takes the bruise and fills our hearts with glory.
My God.
Sing the song.
When Jesus comes, the desert mountain is broken.
Hallelujah.
When Jesus comes, all tears are wiped away.
Oh.
Hey.
Jesus come.
Lift your hand and sing it again. Prayer time in the house.
When Jesus comes,
dear God.
The
dear God.
When Jesus comes.
Hey.
All tears.
Get your anointing. Get your anointing. Receive. Jesus. Lift your hands, close your eyes, sing the song. Some of you don't get touch us yet. Sing the song. Let God touch you. Let Him touch you. Wherever you are, His hands are not short. His ears are not heavy. Call him. He takes
the blue with glory
for all his saints. When Jesus. One more time, just one more time.
When Jesus comes, the desert sky is broken. When Jesus comes,
hallelujah!
All tears,
hallelujah! For all is changed when Jesus comes. Everybody pray. Every man, woman, boy, girl, pray. Pray.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Glory to God. Jesus, breathe upon us again, God. We want more of you, Jesus. More of your power. More of your anointing. Glory to God. More of you, God, to run to our troops. And to leap our wall for 2012 and onward. God, we realize that we can't do it alone. And here we are, God, before you, God. Broken Jesus. Asking you, God, to anoint us again. A fresh God from the crown of our heads.
God, we know the anointing will attract warfare. But we are ready, God. When we are anointed, God, things will never be the same. In the name of Jesus, help us, God, to spend time before you. Holy Ghost of God, Lord, many things are ahead. But we know, God, that we spend time before you, God, on our knees, great God. Oh, God, seeking you, God. You tell us, God, if we seek you, we shall find you. When we search for you with all of our hearts, oh, glory to God. Anoint again, God. Anoint again. Glory to God. Lord, we know the weapons of our warfare, they are not carnal, but they are mighty through God to the pulling on a very stronghold of the enemy. So God, help us to be ready. Help us, oh God, to spend quality time with you, seeking your face, God, and touching your grace. Glory to God. Help us, mighty God, to be wrapped up, to be tied up, to be tangled up in you, God. Oh, glory to God. Oh, Jesus, breathe again upon us, God. Give us a fresh look, a fresh outlook, God, a new focus in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. We thank you, God, for your words. Oh, God, challenging us, mighty God, to stay anointed for 2012 and onward. All the different challenges we are going to face, we need the anointing, nothing less than the anointing, in the name of Jesus. Have your way, God, in our lives, as we seek to please you, as we seek to live for you. Glory to God. Let that be our desire. Let that be a desire of our heart, in the name of Jesus, to live an exemplary life before you, God. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen.
Well, glory, lift up your hands and give him praise now. Come on. Freestyle praises. Open your mouth. Come on. God's people, give him thanks. This is a brand new year, a brand new day. The prospects are good under God. Yes, the prospects are good under God. For all Jamaicans. For all Jamaicans. Visit us to this island. The prospects are good. The eternal Father will bless our land. Yeah. That's why I need thee, oh, I need thee every hour. I need thee, oh, bless me now, my Savior. I come. One more time, one more time, one more time. I need thee, oh, I need thee. Bless me now.
Oh, bless me now, my Savior.
I come to thee.
I come to thee.
Lord, we thank you for today. We thank you for the ministries that you have sent to bless our hearts through the various ones. Thank you for the Holy Spirit. Thank you for the spoken word. Save the lost among us. Reclaim the backsliders. Give strength to the believer. Glorify your name, Father.
In Jesus' name, I ask you to bless every person. May this brand new year bring new streams of blessing in all the hearers of life. Bless our government elect, the cabinet that will be sworn in. Bless them, Lord. Make them successful. In the name of Jesus Christ, and may all the honor and glory and praise be given to you. Bless your servants, the apostles and prophets, evangelists and pastors and teachers. Bless every Christian worker. In Jesus' name. Amen. Clap your hands and shout the I praise, everybody. Hallelujah.
Anointing fall on me. Anointing fall on me. Let the power.